Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be reviewing and demoing the brand new Pat McGrath Labs Star Wars collection for you guys. Such cool products. So if you are interested in hearing my thoughts on these products and seeing them in action, then just keep watching. This collection, I feel like, just came out of nowhere. If you don't know Pat McGrath, she is a huge Star Wars fan. You can also like just look at her products. They're all very galactic themed, stars, things like that. So she's always been such a huge fan of Star Wars that her brand collaborated with Disney and they created a Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker collection. So if you are a huge Star Wars fan, this is such a great collector's item for you to pick up. Let me preface this by saying, I personally, I'm not a Star Wars fan. I don't really follow Star Wars movies. My mom does, so this collection definitely has much more meaning to her, so these products will probably go to her. So when I describe these products, I'm very sorry if I don't understand the references or know the characters. I'm just talking about the makeup. But anyways, yes, so collaborated with Disney on this collection. I know all of you Star Wars fans are super excited. This collection is currently available on the Pat McGrath website and Selfridges as well. If you're in the UK, Selfridges is a great place for you to get Pat McGrath. However, the majority of the items are currently sold out. The collection sold out very quickly. On December 26th, in 2 days, one item in the collection is the Decadence palette, which was limited edition a couple of years ago. A lot of you were very sad that you couldn't pick it up. So now this is in the collection and it has cool Star Wars packaging. I'm not going to be picking that up because I already own the palette, but if you didn't get a chance to pick that palette up or you want the really neat Star Wars packaging, this might be perfect for you. I think it's awesome that she brought this palette back based on popular demand, and it was in a cool way. I think it's cool that she brought it in with this collection. Also in this collection, you get two of her 6-pan eyeshadow palettes and then 4 lip products. Now, something that I want to stress about this collection is that all of the items in here are more so collector's items, so there are repeats of shades. All of the lip colors already exist, and I believe there's a couple of shades in the eyeshadow palettes that are already existing, but I just feel like this is such a very niche collection that that's okay. And also, most people don't own everything from Pat McGrath like me, so I don't see that being a major issue. I purchased everything in the collection besides the Decadence palette. So let's take a quick overview. So like I said, you get two of her 6-pan eyeshadow palettes. Both of them have the Star Wars characters on them that I don't know who they are. Please don't shame me for knowing nothing about Star Wars. I'm so sorry. And then you have 4 of the lip products. Now you can see that the packaging is very, very on theme, very unique. I think that everything in this collection was extremely well thought out. Let's take a deeper dive into the eyeshadow palettes. Now, each of the eyeshadow palettes are the little mothership palettes. They are $65 each, or you can get them in a bundle for $115 on the Pat McGrath Labs website. So the two eyeshadow palettes, we have Galactic Gold and Dark Galaxy. The packaging of these are different from the regular eyeshadow palettes in her line. They kind of look the same, which I love because it's a piece of art, but I really like that it doesn't come in a cardboard box. This is literally, this is literally just the packaging. I think this makes it feel a little bit more expensive to me. Like, those boxes were great, but it was annoying for me to have to unwind that string every day to pull the palette out. I really am enjoying the packaging of this. I like that it's all in one. And it's probably cheaper to make for her too, but super duper cute. I love it. And then here it says the Star Wars logo on it. And then when you open it up, you have a mirror, and this reveals the 6 shades of the Galactic Gold. This one has all shimmer formulas, no mattes in here. We have one more of a flaky duochrome color. This right here is a pure duochrome color. This color right here has some infused glitters. And then you have three neutral shimmer colors, which I think are very dupable within her own line. She often has dark glittery purple colors as well in her other palettes, so that one isn't very unique. I would say the most unique colors in here are these two right here. This is a strong duochrome. Sometimes it looks really red, sometimes it looks blue, sometimes it looks periwinkle. I actually really like this. Sometimes duochromes I feel can be a bit unflattering on the eye. I feel like this one is very flattering on the eye, and this is a very unique kind of flaky duochrome lid topper, but very gorgeous, applies very beautifully to the eyes. And then we have Dark Galaxy right here with the red packaging, and then you open it up and this one definitely looks a lot more plummy based. In here you get a matte shade, and then you get a really dark matte with flecks of glitter in it, but once you blend it out, I would say it's more so of a matte shade. And then I would say you get three of her regular kind of shimmer formulas. This shade has a little bit of glitter, and then you have a fun duochrome shade right here. In this particular one, you are getting a little bit more variety of finishes. I'm gonna say right now, this one is my favorite of the two. I am so obsessed with this one. This color right here is one of the most gorgeous colors in this whole collection, along with this duochrome shade right here. It really transforms a look. That's what adds the pink glitteriness to my eye. I'm obsessed with that. And overall, I just think this is a much more well-rounded palette. It's easier to create looks with, but you definitely need to be into this color scheme. For this one right here, if you are more of a neutral lover, I think you will probably get more use out of this. I'm a huge fan of this color, but based on my own personal preferences, I much prefer the Dark Galaxy. But across the board, the formulas in these palettes are on par with her regular formula. Extremely buttery, extremely easy to apply, minimal fallout. Now, I own just about everything from Pat McGrath, and I can't say anything bad about these eyeshadow palettes. And I have to say, they look even more gorgeous in person than they do online. I'm not gonna lie, I was underwhelmed is the wrong word. I knew these palettes were going to be pretty, but I wasn't like, I need them now. But as soon as I opened up this one in particular, the Dark Galaxy, I was like, this one is definitely one of my favorite six pans that she has come out with. This palette as well also excited me, but that Dark Galaxy. So 10 out of 10 on these. So quickly, let me talk about how I got this look. You guys know I love purples, so I was all for it. So the first shade that I took was from the Dark Galaxy palette, and I took the only matte that is available in this collection right here, and I really like this color. I tried to blow it out pretty softly all over my crease. It's a great base color for all of the shades in these two palettes. Blended out very easily, was very easy to work with. The next shade that I took was this dark purple right here with the glitters, and I packed it onto my outer corner and tried to blend that out. This was leading to a very, very smoky eye look. This color was a little bit more hard to work with because it is a dark plum with some specks of glitter in there. It was easy enough to work out. It was easy enough to blend in with that original matte color, and that just kind of laid the whole base for the eye look. The color that, in my opinion, kind of stole the show was from the Galactic Gold palette. So I took this duochrome shade right here with my finger, and I just applied it right over that dark purple color and into the center of my lid where there wasn't any color, and you could really see how that base color changed the look to add some more depth as well. And oh my gosh, so pretty, just right here. Applied like butter, super simple, and then I squeezed back into the Dark Galaxy palette. We're gonna go back and forth a lot. And I took this shade because it is so stunning. It's a very like gray purple with a little bit of gold flecks, and I applied that inward a little bit more, but I still had space left on my eyelid because I was trying to create a gradient, and that color, super pretty. It's gonna be stunning all over the lid for another look. I went into this shade right here and I applied that to my inner corner. What I really love about this color is that it added just like a really pretty pink glimmer to the lid, and you can put this over any shadow of any of these palettes and it's going to transform your look. It's a little bit more flaky, it's a unique texture, but it adheres to the lid very well. From Galactic Gold, I took this shade right here and I patted it into my inner corner. Again, it's a little flaky, but it adheres to the lid very well. So that's my inner corner color. And then the last thing that I did was I had lined my lower lash line with the matte colors, and then I went in with the reddish cranberry shade right here, and I applied that right to the inner half of my lower lash line just to add a fun red element. Cranberry really flatters these cool toned purples. So that is how I got this look. I applied a little bit of purple eyeliner to my lower lash line, and of course some falsies, and that's how we got this look. So overall, I am very impressed with these eyeshadow palettes. I think they are beautiful. Even if you aren't a fan of Star Wars, these are just generally beautiful eyeshadow palettes. So I'm very happy with these. So now let's move on to the lip colors. Now all of the colors in this collection are from her original line, and all of them are very on theme. Now they are $40 each, which is quite pricey, and I bought the whole lip collection, and I think if you are not a Star Wars fan, you don't need them, but let me show you what I got. So three of them are actually like her lip balm formula, and I actually have never tried it before. So this is the Lip Fetish in clear, and this is R2D2, I do know that. And of course the packaging is spectacular, and the packaging of this is even more spectacular. Like, this is a little R2D2, my mom was very excited about it. And then you have her lip balm. I think her lip balm formula is a bit overpriced. It's very nice, and it's definitely about the whole experience of the product, so I'm not gonna say it's not worth it. I definitely don't feel the need to buy another Pat McGrath lip balm again. Didn't want to show you that. And then she also has two other of her lip balms. However, they are like the astral ones, so there's a glitter in them, and don't be fooled by the advertisements where there's a light on somebody's lips and they're super glittery. The glitter does show up on your lips, but it is very minimal. This is the Fetish lip balm in nude astral, and then you have a Lip Fetish lip balm in gold astral. And for you Star Wars fans, here's what the packaging looks like. Nude astral, here is what the packaging looks like. And this one has like a pinky gold glitter to it. It doesn't feel really gritty on the lips. Like, these are a very nice formula, and they do add a little bit of glimmer to the lips, but I'm not overly impressed by it. And then gold astral, beautiful all gold packaging. Like, this kind of makes it worth it. I love this all gold, and this has a golden glitter to it. So these aren't too exciting to really show. I struggle to show the glitter on camera, so that's just more about the packaging more than anything, if you ask me. And there was one regular lip color. This is in the shade Flesh 3, but these are the sheer color balms. So this one's all gold, and yeah, this is a sheer color, all gold packaging, and it looks very, very intimidating, but of course it's a sheer color. I did apply it in a clip that I will show you here. It just looked a little crazy with the look that I'm wearing, so I didn't have it on the whole video, but it is a super nice smooth formula. It almost feels like a lip balm with a strong tint to it, and I actually really like this color. I think if you're afraid of reds, this is a very nice color, and I think the formula is very smooth and comfortable as well, so I am into this. This is the first time I've tried the sheer color formula, and really, really good. So I would say the lip stuff in this collection didn't really wow me. I'm not super excited about them, but if you are a Star Wars fan, definitely these are great collector's pieces. The actual product isn't that great, but the packaging is what seals the show for these. So that's all I have for today's review of the new Star Wars collection from Pat McGrath. Overall, the eyeshadow palettes I'm very, very highly impressed with. Definitely recommend them if you're a Star Wars fan or not. The lip products, however, definitely only am recommending them if you like Star Wars. Let me know your thoughts on this collection. Did you guys get your hands on it? I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Let me know your thoughts below. And thank you guys for watching. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, make sure you do so. And of course, like this video. It really helps my channel out. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys, have a good one.